It is your PrisonPlanet.tv memberships that fund so much of what we do here on this operation. And we're more than happy for the TV show after it's aired live, then be leaked out onto the web to tens of millions of people. That's our goal. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome and thank you for joining us here on this Thursday edition, the 12th day of April, 2012. And as you can hear, my voice is a little bit raspy today, but I think it'll, like an old car's engine, after it runs for a while, it should stop sputtering and clanking and whiz-banging. We have reporters. In fact, guys, we pulled me yesterday's news, Paul Watson's article on the death, the suspicious death of the gentleman who had a small farm that the city designated as a green space and decided to take. And so they kept bringing charges forward for a very long period of time. Against him, he kept winning in court, so the house just blew up, and with him in it, when the police outside, and of course, somebody also, months before, had poisoned his chickens, and it made the city even madder, because it was out in a rural area. It's a suburb of Atlanta, they're in Georgia, they're in Roswell, Georgia. Others were getting into having backyard chickens. And you don't do that in America. Pittsburgh is moving to ban garage sales. And, of course, the feds have $15 million fines now if you sell anything that was ever recalled, even though you don't know that. You're supposed to know that. If you sell anything that was ever recalled, $15 million fine. That's Associated Press. If you think I'm joking, just search that term. I've got more attacks on Amish and more attacks on people selling produce on the side of the road. You're not going to do that. Pretty soon, they won't even let a gentleman, I guess, in South Austin sell bonsai trees on the side of the road. You don't do that in land of the free, home of the brave. You pay your money to a big box store with Chinese slave goods, with factories that move to China because of tax incentives. And if you don't like it, you can go to jail. In land of the free, home of the brave. I don't know why my voice is gone today, but it's one thing when my voice is raspy, but it's another thing entirely when it's hard to talk. So hopefully my afterburners will kick in here, and I don't feel bad. It's just laborious to talk. That's coming up. I'm going to have our reporters, Darrin McBreen and Marcos Morales, reporting from Roswell, Georgia, home of Ted Turner and the Georgia Guidestones nearby, their testament to genocidal hatred of humanity. They're going to be joining us in the third hour, which actually distracts them and away from their work. They're investigating the suspicious death. You know, they announce in about 5 minutes they think he blew himself up in the house. When they do that, we have to automatically not believe known congenital liars that are government. And, you know, that's my issue with the police. A lot of police I know are patriotic, smart men and women and are good people and got into it for the right reasons. But they work for and serve a corrupt political elite and carry out unconstitutional stuff all the time. And yes, I will later in the hour break down Austin's own karma-geddon. You're like, well, I don't live in Austin. Why do I care? This type of stuff is going on everywhere. That police officer got killed last week by a Xanax head. They shut down both sides of the major highways and paralyze the city for 5 hours. Welcome, my friends. Welcome. We are live. Thank you for joining us. It is the 12th day of April, 2012, on this Thursday worldwide broadcast, and we're going to be here for the next 3 hours. We're going to have our reporters, Marcos Morales and Darrin McBreen, joining us from a suburb of Atlanta, Roswell, Georgia, where a man locked in a six-year battle with the city that was telling him he couldn't have his farm that they had annexed into the city, ended up dying when the police began to raid his home. And they're telling us that the gentleman blew himself up. So we've got reporters there talking to the locals and investigating, and they'll be joining us coming up in the third hour of the broadcast today. Headline at Infowars.com, state seizes property under green zoning laws. They designated the land. They said they were going to get it. And they said, you can't have chickens. And he went to court and beat them. He'd had chickens for years. And it didn't matter. It didn't matter. And, of course, they've got the property now. Another citizen conquered. Agenda 21 eco-fascism bears its teeth. And it's broken down in that article. We'll cover that for about 30 minutes of the third hour today. Meanwhile, there's more hysteria. NBC New York reports suspicious package forces evacuation of World Financial Center Tower. The wicked flee when none pursue. Yesterday, we were reporting that, and so was Fox News and others, that there was leaks coming out that, no, they weren't going to charge George Zimmerman and the Trayvon Martin slaying. And then, before the show was even over, they came out and said they were charging him with second-degree murder, which has shocked prosecutors across the country. They said, bare minimum, you might get a conviction with manslaughter, which is basically accidental. Second-degree murder is a big deal. I guess all there is after that is premeditated capital murder, which is the death penalty. Now, suddenly, Trayvon Martin's mother has come out and said that she thinks that it was a accident, and the leader of the new Black Panther Party, we're going to play this later, has broken down crying and freaking out. Turns out she's got a long history of run-ins with the police. She's now apologizing, saying she never incited anyone to violence, and then cries. It's about the worst performance I've ever seen, and I guess she's worried now about being arrested for racketeering. Because they call on people to organize to murder whites and to, quote, burn down Florida. I mean, that's organizing criminal attacks. That is the essence of organized crime. And you notice she hadn't gotten in trouble, but I think the way she's crying and freaking out now and then saying, and by the way, I never incited anybody. I guess her lawyer told her that. She's getting the word that she's going to get some handcuffs slapped on her, and she needs to. I mean, where is the grand jury? Where is the prosecutor calling for this Tampa, Florida woman to be arrested? I mean, anybody else? If this wasn't being run out of the White House and NBC hadn't been caught editing tapes so that they can get a race war going, and if the White House wasn't, you know, hyping this up, and if the Attorney General wasn't meeting with Al Sharpton, who is a clown-like race agitator, she would be arrested very, very quickly. And, of course, the feds also in Orlando, on record, Orlando Sentinel, have white supremacist groups that are admittedly fed-run, not fed-infiltrated, fed-run trying to stir up a thing as well. And they've called for things not quite as extreme, but close. They're not getting in any trouble. But every time I have national media here, every time, they say, aren't you calling for violence? Aren't you worried you're going to cause violence? When I'm calling for non-violence and awakening to the fact that we're going into a tyranny. Doesn't matter who it is. Nightline, the list goes on and on. MSNBC, all of them. They always say, what about violence? Meanwhile, NBC is editing tapes together trying to get a race war going. The idea is, oh, there's violence in America. We got to shut down everybody's free speech. But they want to stir it up first so they have the pretext to shut down the population speech. And that's exactly what the system's doing. There's new numbers I'll get to later if I have time. Broadcast TV and cable viewing across the board is just plummeting. Primetime shows are plummeting. People are just deserting the dinosaur media. And so the system is going to respond with the new treaties and new laws and new cybersecurity legislation that, in their own words, ends privacy, ends due process, and allows them to shut down anybody anytime they want outside of law. And that's the big issue here that has to be discussed. The larger issue that we need to understand here is that when I get up here and criticize police for engaging in unconstitutional activity, you are being twisted by the social engineers to slowly destroy the common law, the common sense, the Bill of Rights, due process. And the entire society is being criminalized and being inducted into the criminal justice system that today is a social engineering college for criminals. That's how the system plans to fully erase our rights and liberties, is just set up administrative law, train bureaucrats and armed bureaucrats that they can do whatever they want administratively, and then get everybody into the system and say you don't have rights. No fly list. IRS wants it where you can't have a job, travel. If you aren't in good stead with them, and they're a collection agency for the private Federal Reserve and want to destroy the economy in their own policy reports, they want to create a post-industrial society. That's what's going on here. And so when they try to set it out there in front of the public, like you're either for the police and do everything they say and do and everything the media promotes through them and everything that the government that commands them says, or you hate police. And that's not the case. But in every case in history, in every culture, tyranny comes to your door in a uniform. The uniform is always the instrument of your enslavement. And it's that case in all histories, in all cultures, in all systems. Many cultures, in fact, the more free, the less police. Many cultures outlawed police, outlawed military in the country. Our system outlawed military inside the United States. That's the American system, because they knew it would be used against us by corrupt individuals that got control. In Germany, the military was pretty much outlawed from operating domestically, but Hitler got rid of that. Before Julius Caesar came along, you could not have the military inside of Italy. What is Italy today? Rome was a city-state, and its main province and its genetic homeland was what is Italy today. But the city on the hills there was the city-state of Rome. And you did not bring the military in to central and southern Italy. You could have them up in the north, but that was it, to guard the border. So see, these are common sense things. And you say, our police are being militarized. They're violating our rights more and more. We're being trained that we basically can't have any rights or freedoms, and that it's all in our own interest. And then the government's caught engaged in all this corruption and all this abuse and all these dangerous things that are happening. We need to rein government back in. That's the American system. And then we get rebuked by the dinosaur media and the police spokesman and others. And now our local police are being federalized for all intents and purposes with Homeland Security money. There is the manifest joke of the drug war, where you've had scores of congressional hearings, certifications by the CIA Inspector General in 1997, that yes, the agency for decades did bring in every drug you can imagine. constantly government is caught shipping drugs in. It doesn't get in trouble because it's sanctioned shipping guns to drug gangs over the border. Police officers get killed, and there's not big parades and cities shut down. The people are told there'll be a couple folks out there at the funeral. Shut up if you want their pension. What is it? At least three police officers and now three Border Patrol? The number's more like 19, according to our sources, but they can't 100% prove. Because the Justice Department comes in and they'll debate, well, there was some guns from Fast and Furious with the people that killed the cop, but we think it's this gun that they got somewhere else. It's just, it's so sick. And then meanwhile, they shut the entire city down for 5 hours yesterday. I-35, 71, it was a living nightmare. Busiest thoroughfare in the country is I-35 in the swath from Austin to San Antonio. I mean, it's traffic at high noon. There's traffic there at midnight a lot of times, you know, bumper to bumper. Total shutdown. People couldn't get their kids for hours. And I heard the local talk show host and the police spokesman on the local radio attacking the public like we were scum and saying that you were told there was going to be this motorcade. Shut up. And it was just like the animosity. People didn't know coming down I-35 from all over the country why it was shut down for hours after hour. But it gets worse. It, San Angelo, where they took the poor police officer's body to be laid to rest, is northwest of Austin. They took the body south to parade him around in showboat. Okay, let me try to hit on a few of the other news stories that we've got here in front of us. And then I'm going to give the number out. In fact, I'll do that right now. And then I'm going to come back and cover from a psychology and criminology perspective what happened in Austin, Texas yesterday where I live. And again, this affects people all over the country. This was a pure psyop on the back of a dead police officer. And it shows how the system manipulates. All these cops dead from Fast and Furious guns into the hands of criminals by the Justice Department. There's not parades for them. There's not shutting down cities for them. I went and looked it up. They kept it very quiet. The system uses officers that are killed to make the government look like heroes. Just like they did with 9/11 first responders, who they then attacked in the New York Post as ambulance chasers wanting medical treatment. They wouldn't even get medical treatment. It took 9 years and an act of Congress to get them basic medical treatment. Hey, you're sick, you're off the fire department, and we're not going to give you treatment. Oh, yeah. The police, the firemen and women. Again, I'm sick of this fake sentimentalism where the system manipulates us. I mean, what I saw here in Austin yesterday was like something out of North Korea. And I'm not saying the people involved were bad. It just shows how they were manipulated. In fact, I know the feds were involved in organizing some of it, but guys, look into how this was orchestrated. Next time Arde Saveda comes in here, I mean, I challenge him. Because I heard the radio yesterday, they were saying that he had called in and made statements that if people don't like the traffic, he doesn't care. And again, it just goes to disconnected from reality. And the way the public was then attacked by the talk show host and the callers going, I'll beat somebody up if I don't see them pull over. Folks, the media was saying pull over when they shut I-35 completely down. The busiest highway in the country and the busiest stretch. See, I'm already covering this. It's just so amazing. And I'm going to try to, in a focused way, cover it all after the break because we got a bunch of graphics and documents I want to go over. They shut it down, and then they told everyone, the police department did, the news media echoed it, that to show respect, you should stop on the other side of the road. So the other side, both lanes, like there'd been a nuclear spill or something, were shut down, both northbound and southbound, and it shut the entire city down because people all went off the other roads. There were cars wrecking. My wife saw cars crashing into each other, people driving on the medians, bedlam. This is a big city with not enough roads because the environmentalists have blocked them. We're under Gen 21 here completely. And it was insanity. People couldn't get their children. Yeah, look at that on the local news. Go back and show that and pause that real quick. Go back and show it. Where it shows them. Let's just do it after the break. Just stop, okay? Yeah, look, the other side of the highway shut down, quote, out of respect. And this went on for 5 hours in Austin. And then hour after hour. But here's the big one. Here's the big one. I was looking at it. I go, San Angelo's north of Austin. Why did they go south? And they did it to shut everything down on purpose to make a giant spectacle. And according to that thought process, get a parade permit, announce when you're going to do it on a weekend so everybody who wants to come out and pay respects can, and shut down Congress and give the guy a parade if you want. Okay, fine. Gave his life. Whatever, great, I'm all for it. Do not, in the middle of the day and into the daytime traffic, shut everything down. And I'm going to show you the maps if you're watching on PrisonPlanet.tv and go all over. And people are like, hey, man, we got North Korea about to launch a missile. We got global depression. We'll get to all that. This, though, is about the mindset of government. And as a psyop, how the public responded. When they're told to be sentimental and care, they do. When they shoot a kid up with the vaccines, they die on the spot, nobody cares. Because the media is not told to care. We'll be back. We are back live. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to get into the Karma-geddon thing and the different psychological angles on it. Coming up at the start of the next hour for just one segment. I'm going to try to keep it condensed down to just one area. And go over the fact that ambulances couldn't get places, people couldn't pick their children up, in some cases for 2 hours plus. The major highway was completely shut down. There were no police to be seen anywhere writing the customary tickets and revenue generating. And I'm told that they couldn't really respond to a lot of calls. And it's just like, it doesn't matter. We're going to shut down everything, and we're going to route a vehicle completely out of the way and shut down both sides of the highways and turn the city into total gridlock. And then if you complain about it and say, why did you do this? We're going to say you're a traitor and hate police because you're just a scumbag citizen here to pay taxes. And helicopters and the police chief crying. I mean, I've never seen this. The last police officer was Officer Jones, who died back in 2000 when some scumbag shot him when he pulled him over. And it is a tough, thankless job. My whole point is that the system wants to lionize police to God level and try to set up an idea that they are rock star superheroes so that you cannot ever criticize them. So when the state gives them orders that are criminal and dangerous and try to use them for tyranny, the psyop is you can't say no. And so that is all coming up later in the transmission. What I'm going to do right now is just open the phones up on any subject you want to discuss. What's happening to the economy, the threats of North Korea to go to war if anybody gets in the way of their missile being launched. Our corporate media criticizing North Korea and talking about how horrible the government is and how the people are starving. Well, I mean, you like total government. Our government does a lot of stuff like North Korea. And, of course, I can compare that. The public out crying, who didn't even know the police officer, and waving American flags. They're desperate for America to come back. They're desperate for something to believe in. And when the media says, have a race war over Trayvon Martin, it starts. People start getting killed. And when they say, when you see this driving on the other side of the highway, you'll pull over out of respect. As they shut down the other side of the highway. But then when a cop gets killed by the Justice Department's guns, or when the Justice Department kills Cop of the Year in Oklahoma, because he knew the feds were planting bombs in the building. Terrence Yakey and the head of the canine unit and others are witnesses to what the feds were doing. They come to him and say, we'll kill you and your family if you don't shut up. And then the cop, the police officers, it's three of them separately, go to the police chief. The police chief says, get out of my office. Better keep your mouth shut. Hey, chief, feds are threatening to kill me and my family if I talk about what I saw. Well, you better keep your mouth shut then, buddy. See, it's all fake. It's a psyop. That's my point. It's not about the police officer who was killed. It's about the fact that it's a giant psychological operation. And that it's getting more and more crazy when a police officer gets killed. Where they act like the earth stands still. When they want to, is the point. And the question is, why did they want to route it through the middle of the city in rush hour and shut the entire city down into total gridlock and bedlam? I mean, when Bill Clinton used to do that, or George Bush, people got mad, and rightfully so. What do you need, 100 cars? Why are you blocking highways? You're not the emperor. You're not Kim Jong-il. This is North Korea stuff, man. They shut the highways down in dictatorships. The people hated Ceausescu in Romania because he did stuff like that. American presidents didn't used to do this. Unless the city decided to give the president a parade, then there was a parade route. Not just as the president lands for fundraisers, they shut down the highway. It happens. Obama's here 4 or 5 times a year. And I usually don't go home till 7 or 8 or 9 at night, but sometimes we'll run out to get something to eat. And we're right here by I-35 and 290, and the airport's over there. And they'll just have police blocking the exits and things and entrances, and we can't go anywhere. And they'll block the road, you know, 20 minutes before. When his plane lands, and sometimes he'll sit there for an hour, they start blocking the road. And you're just like, oh, the road's blocked because the king is here. That's what I'm sick of. I really have a problem with that. And so now the local bureaucrats, let me tell you, if they get away with using this dead cop to do this, it's an exercise of power. It's a showboating. They're going to start doing it. They had a police dog killed a few years ago. I'm already covering this. They had a police dog killed in Houston, and on the news it said thousands of police on taxpayer money went there, and they had shut down a part of the roads for the dog and called in an officer and charged the guy with killing an officer under some weird twist of the law for shooting the dog. And I'm not saying that's good, but and I'm a big dog lover. I've got 4 dogs, 2 French bulldogs, a black lab, and an aged chihuahua. Okay, I got 4 dogs. But let me tell you, this is what happens in Rome. In Rome, they begin to elevate the emperor's dogs and the emperor's bulls, their champion bulls, and their horses above the people. It always is the same. And this was all about worship police, but not individually. The state wears the police as a cloak of infallibility. It's just really weird. Most of the time when I run into police, if you're nice to them, then they start asking you questions and looking at you weird. So I just like, don't even really talk to them. I'm just like, okay. It was like they had 2 police came out because an alarm went off at my house. I don't know why it's been going off in the middle of the night. And I go up there to talk to them. And they both recognize who I am. I tell them who I am, tell them squirrels are eating the wires or something. And the male officer starts walking away, and the woman says, can I see your ID? And I could tell she was smiling at me. It was like an exercise of power. And I said, yeah. And I pulled out my wallet out of my back pocket, and she looked at it and smiled at me. It was just a little, and I was like, whatever, man. If that's what makes your ego feel good, if that's what makes you feel good in life, is to have somebody show you their ID while they're wearing jeans and no shirt, standing in the dark. You're shining a flashlight in her face. I was just like, whatever. And my point is I think she did that because I said, thanks for coming out. Be safe, you know. And she turned back around and said, let me see your ID. And it was like, okay. And I knew as soon as I said something nice to him, that was the trigger. I just know so much about psychology now and how people work, and I'm just sick of it, man. I'm so sick of it. And the banks that have captured this country are forging a oppressive, unconstitutional system. I mean, I don't blame, quote, all police for the fact that every 3 or 4 days I see articles where they're taking people's children at the hospital because they refuse vaccines. There's no law. It's not neglect. And they're kidnapping children. And they're following the orders of the pedophile services. The child pedophile services, CPS. The pedophile delivery service. And I know it's a crime, and I know they're hurting people's children, and it affects me. And I know they have special units attached, in many cases, to CPS and hospitals that are pervs and are part of the team. I was talking to a well-known musician, and he talked about how they groped his 14-year-old daughter, the TSA. Now they single out his wife because they're, you know, she's attractive. And I mean, you see people, and you see 14-year-old girls with pot-bellied men and women grabbing their breast. I mean, this is the sacrament. I guess you should wave an American flag and cry. Oh, here's my 5-year-old daughter. Grope them, and then you wave an American flag, and that makes, and it's like, if you don't like it, you know, wave an American flag. They can start coating cyanide pills with a little American flag cover, you know, on the pill. It's like, take cyanide, and you're like, I don't want to die. And they're like, it has an American flag on it. You see how it's just, it's a gimmick. It's just totally shallow and fake and being done because it's fake. It'd be like if somebody brought you cookies when you moved into a neighborhood and came up and was real nice and gave you the cookies and told you how nice they were to bring you cookies. You'd go, oh, this neighbor, they're not bringing me cookies to be friendly. They want something. The next day, hey, mind if I leave my dog with you this weekend when I'm going out of town? And you're like, sure. And they get back, hey, mind if you pick me up from work? You know, it's the gimmick of it. It's that it's a manipulation. It's that the public is looked at by the social engineers, and the local ones all want to play that game. It's all how to package info, how to manipulate, how to punch people's buttons. It's like a month or so ago, Santorum said something, you know, about women and birth control. And Limbaugh came out and, you know, talked about a woman who wanted thousands of dollars of contraceptive a year. And he's like, man, you know, you want us to pay for what, you know, for your sexual activity? I mean, what is that when you pay someone so they can have sexual activity? What is that called? And they made a huge deal, and Obama went up like 10 plus points or more in some polls with women. Total con artist, reading off a teleprompter, lied about everything. But you know what? He's skinny and handsome and acts friendly and like a sitcom star. So it's like, hey, you know what? Go ahead and rape me real bad. You know what? It's a gimmick, and I'm sick of gimmicks. There's nobody putting makeup on me. There's nobody telling me what to say. This is real. And sure, I wear a sports jacket to respect the information. I was talking about a dead police officer today. I put a sports jacket on. You know, there's little things like that. We try to make it, you know, an interesting show. But the point is that that's not what's up front. That's not what our foundation is. And this is a culture that is 1,000 miles wide and one atom deep. You ever heard the saying, all hat and no cattle? Most people wearing cowboy hats and cowboy boots and strutting around talking like John Wayne are like John Wayne. They're not from Texas. They're from Ohio. Nothing wrong with being from Ohio. Of course, John Wayne did embrace the Western culture and get all into it. The point is, I don't blame him, is that it's all hat and no cattle. You understand the difference between that? All hat and no cattle. Mile wide, inch deep. They're not real. People revel in the fakeness. And it's like you're an open, this is so important I'm going to say right now, it's like you're an open, programmable computer that just receives what you're told. So the media in a PSYOP test, this is what this was. This is never, I've never seen anything like this anywhere, with a police officer, a president, anything. I mean, this was crazy. And it was a PSYOP. Arde Saveda is slick. The Austin police chief. This was a PSYOP for a few days before to say, you will stop when you see it come by on the other side of the road. And we're going to shut down I-35. And we're going to shut down 290. And we're going to shut down 71. And we're going to go the opposite direction of the town northwest of Austin. And we're going to drive through the middle of Austin from North Austin. I mean, they were right there on the big toll road that goes right out to a big highway, straight shot directly to the town, you know, 55, 60 miles away, San Angelo. And they went all the way down into South Austin and all the way down around South. I mean, the MapQuest and the Google Maps wouldn't program in that route. Normally, you can do alternate routes. It will not take the programmed route. That's the route they took. I have it on screen. And that's just in Austin. When you back out, you can see the map there. And, of course, the statesman doesn't show the road that's right up there in North Austin and goes right out to San Angelo. And they did this to shut everything down because it's a PSYOP. They sat there, experts at traffic control, DPS command, as they're called, highway command, you know, getting their Homeland Security armored mobile pillboxes for us because we're the enemy with our tax money and gunboats with the giant machine gun arrays and to fight drug smugglers when the government's shipping the drugs in, to fight smugglers that didn't launder their money with them. They shut everything down as an exercise of power. And see, I know history. So I know that kings in China and Japan and in Mayan cultures and in British culture and in ancient French culture and Roman culture, they would shut roads, the Romans would, to mark the death of an emperor. Just everything stops. You're going to learn that we have the power. When I was in London last time taking a tour, so I was just using one of the open back buses to shoot some video, so I got the tour. And when I got back, I looked it up. It was true. They, every week, every day, the Queen shuts down different parts of the city. And they say, today these streets are closed. She's exercising her divine right. And she owns the streets of London and is shutting down these major roads today. And she shuts down the River Thames sometimes to exercise the power. To show it's yours, that you don't have right away. That's an ancient common law. And they let us know. They said, listen, you're going to pay respects. And you know what they did? Kids everywhere. Because you hear there's going to be a parade for an officer in the background. You're like, oh, well, that's nice. And then you're like, why is the whole city shut down? I've got to pick my child up at this sporting thing he's at 4. And instead it's 6. And your child is there in a field. And no one can get to them. And ambulances can't get there. And people can't get to police calls. And people driving on I-35 have no idea what's going on. And both sides are shut down. It's just like the attitude of the police chief and everybody was like, literally, I heard this on the radio. I heard them talking about it and it was like, get used to it. Get used to it. Tough luck. It wasn't like, yeah, we're sorry, but you know what? It's for a slain officer. And we understand it caused some inconvenience. Thanks for bearing with us. It's just like, tough luck! Tough luck! And the IRS is going to take your house outside of due process, and they're going to burn your house down if they want it because you got chickens in the backyard, and they're going to arrest people for gardens, and they're going to arrest the Amish, and they're going to take our tax money and pay it to foreign banks, and we're going to go bankrupt, and they're going to have tax incentives to ship our jobs out of the country. All of this is going on. Here's the toll-free number, 800-259-9231. I'll just go to this at the bottom of the next hour. And I got a bunch of news, but I'm going to take your calls. 800-259-9231. More news coming up. All right, look, I'm going to take calls straight through for 30 minutes in the next hour. Then I'll hit Karma-geddon in Austin, Texas. And the poor police chief had to cry every time the cameras got turned on all yesterday. So I know that was rough on him. We got some of this footage. It's unbelievable. I mean, all I know is if I go buy a pair of cowboy boots, you know, I want the real alligator. I don't want plastic ones. And that's what this is. It's plastic, folks. It's like It's like wax food. You ever seen at a restaurant, they'll have examples of their food at diners? It's like, man, that piece of key lime pie looks really good. Or that chicken fried steak and that gravy looks real. It isn't real. And that's what's killing us, is this millimeter deep, mile wide garbage. All hat, no cattle. Because it's like War of the Worlds or something. Where it's this giant psyop. And I'm just fascinated by it. Because within this story is just examples of everything else. And that's what Edward Bernays, the father of modern propaganda, talked about. He said you just launch a bunch of pageantry and you connect to that pageantry whatever message you want. And then, I mean, I'll guarantee you this slain police officer, who everybody I know says was a really nice person, I'll guarantee you if he could have seen what they did, he would have been embarrassed and said, do not do that. Oh, we've got the North Korea footage? Yeah, that's the fake crying in North Korea. And basically, the media told everybody to come out and cry, and that's what happened. Tens of thousands, I think, because it was like hundreds at every overpass, were crying and waving American flags or waving Mexican flags. And it's just like, my wife said, it's very fascist. It's like, this isn't normal. It's not normal in North Korea. It's not normal here to take a route that shuts a whole city down and then yell at people if they're like, man, why are you doing this? And then act like we're weird because it's like everybody's waving American flags. Listen, we know we're in America. Do you understand that what the flag symbolizes has basically been killed? You're like, oh, that's extreme. You want to actually follow what the country's founded on and why we're supposed to honor the flag as the symbol. What the flag symbolizes is being killed. And you get all these stores order their employees out, like North Korea, to put their hands over their heart. Just a big spectacle. It's government worship. I just can't handle it anymore. Oh my God. They were so desperate to have a martyr, they now have big parades for dead dogs. And again, if you want to go to the parade, go to the parade. But no, they said, we're going to make you sit in traffic for hours and not get your children. And then we're going to scream at you on the radio. And everyone, like it's North Korea, is going to say, how dare you even question? You don't do that in America. You don't have Amish in America. You don't refuse vaccines. We'll take your kids with no law. That's what I mean, folks. They've now announced they're spying on everyone without warrants. Totally illegal. And they just want you to know they're spying on you without warrants. They didn't have police parades like this before. That's what I mean. People are like, well, you ought to think this is a good thing. Really? Why is it new? Why do they do this now? Presidents didn't used to have 100 car motorcades and block off huge areas of cities every time they flew into town. Police didn't used to wear black masks. We didn't used to have checkpoints on our highways. We didn't used to have a government shipping guns into Mexico to blame the Second Amendment. We didn't used to have 10,000 plus percentage increase in pediatric cancers. We didn't used to, every public place I go to, there's mentally retarded and autistic and children being damaged by vaccines all around me, everywhere I go. Diabetes, 3,000 percentage increase. We're a cursed nation. And the veneer of it is go out and cry when a cop drives by you don't even know. But when your neighbor's kid gets taken by the CPS for no reason, your neighbor comes for you for help, you're like, I'm sorry, I just can't help you. Mile wide, millimeter deep. All hat, no cattle, man, and I'm tired of it. It's disgusting. And all cultures that are tyrannies are hallmarked by this North Korea type stuff. In North Korea, I was looking it up. If they get somebody killed, they do the same thing for police. Welcome to North Korea of Austin. All right, we're into hour number two. I basically have pontificated about karma-geddon. I haven't even gotten into it. I have this focused info I wanted to go over in a focused presentation. But it's just, it's so bad that we have a government that consciously sees us as programmable robots and that they try to manipulate us 24/7. And I realize the awakening and defeating tyranny is going to be about getting people to just recognize that they're being targeted, they're being manipulated, and that the people running things are predatory and do not have their best interests at heart. Does that mean everybody in the system's bad? No. But the major global corporate system is run by the most wicked, of the most ruthless, of the most degenerate. And it just rolls downhill from that point on. And we've got huge Trayvon Martin news, and obviously a bunch of other stuff we got to go over, and just tyranny popping up everywhere. But, and of course, we launched the national movement to impeach Obama. That video's gone mega viral. I should have been promoting that. I'm devastated right now. It's so crazy. Jim in Ohio. Jim, you're on the air. Welcome.
Hey, Alex. Good to talk to you. Just want to let you know I'm a retired police officer, and I couldn't agree with you more about what's going on with, you know, every time a dignitary comes into town or law enforcement, fireman dies, whatever the case might be, they just make a great big production out of it. And I've been involved in, on both sides of the police funeral thing, both from being one of the cars in the funeral and being stuck sitting alongside the road waiting as a mile-long procession goes by. And
by the way, this was way over a mile. This was like, at one point they said like 5-6 miles long. I mean, I'm telling you, I've seen a lot of stuff. It'd be one, I mean, and then it was the yelling at the public about it when people, I mean, most people didn't even know. I mean, it was just like everything was shut down. Can you imagine a town like Austin when they shut down the two biggest roads? What that, I mean, it was, and you know how the public gets, the reckless driving that starts. I mean, it was scary out there because I went out trying to get my son and couldn't get to him. And it was people just driving like maniacs, and there was no police to then even stop them. I mean, can you imagine what this looked like?
Oh, I can just imagine. You know, that kind of thing would take hours to recover from, and who knows how many wrecks, you know, other kinds of incidents may have been caused because of it, as people, you know, get frustrated and try and go other ways and get in a hurry and do things that they wouldn't normally do, but, you know, just out of the sheer frustration of trying to get around something if they're in a hurry to get someplace, who knows. But, I think it's a vast violation of the people's rights to travel, and it's just another case of the people, the high muckety mucks trying to say, you know, we're in charge and you're going to honor us whether you want to or not.
Well, that's the thing, is it was a giant stunt, also not being able to get my son, you know, really just showed. And now they have these drills where they come take the kids to a federal center and won't tell the parents where they went. I mean, the government's really showing us, hey, we do what we want.
Yeah, I could see them staging something like that, and at the same time, when the parents can't get there, automatically having the CPS or somebody there to take all the kids and say, well, you didn't get them when you were supposed to, so we took control.
Well, that's what I'm saying, is that the people on top are predators. And then the predators want to use the police, the fire department, everybody else that by and large are servants and do a great job in many cases as a shield to make them look good. And just to watch them use this dead officer like this, I mean, it's shameless. It's and then I don't like having to come out and point this out and go against the hype. But, I mean, it just was a frightening production. I want to ask you, as a retired police officer, I think you said, what your view is of the IRS when we come back. Stay there, Leaser. I want to ask your view of them saying they're not going to let you travel if you haven't paid your taxes. I mean, that, folks, is directly out of Stalinist Russia. I mean, it doesn't get any more bona fide. And by the way, that's now in the House. It passed the Senate. Now we'll be back with Jim, then we'll go to Blue, John, Sean, Glenn, and others. Look, we've gotten totally distracted, at least I have, getting off into the fact that a police officer, a Marine veteran, a well-liked fellow was killed by a crazy man on Xanax who had no criminal record in a Walmart. And I talked about this last week. There's no discussion in the media about the Xanax, just like we know that the sergeant that killed all those people was in treatment and they've blocked releasing the records, but the word is he was on psychotropics. I mean, most of the time when somebody just mindlessly kills somebody, they're on mind-altering substances, and it's hardly ever PCP, which does cause that as well. It's psychotropics in the same class. So I'm just tired of the hollowness. I'm tired of the fakeness. Now, I'm going to go back to your calls right now, and then coming up, obviously, our courthouse source was wrong, but the media had been saying that they weren't going to charge him, but I guess they chickened out and were worried about riots, and so they have charged Zimmerman, and now the mother of Trayvon Martin has come out and said she thinks it was an accident, because now they're learning that he marched in black parades for justice for people and stuff, and was not who the new Black Panther Party that says they want a race war said Zimmerman was. And they're going to use it. Our source was right on that, to go after the Second Amendment. They thought it was going to be some type of gun charge. And they are now announcing it'll be part of the 2012 campaign to restrict the Second Amendment and the right of self-defense off this poor young man's death. So that's coming up. They're banning all over the country. They're banning and restricting garage sales. This is part of shutting down the economy, what's left of it. Last week, DHS raids home to seize deadly hair straighteners. Homeland Security's just taking everything over. These threat fusion centers are illegal. It's illegal to have the CIA involved domestically. They don't care. They just say, yeah, we're watching everything you do now. I'm CIA director. Yeah, all the new appliances have devices that watch and listen to you. I'd tell people that 10 years ago and get laughed at when I had the MIT reports. Just like they had a 1970s MIT report where they said they want to kill 90% of us. Now there's a new report out that finally got coverage. I mean, I know it sounds crazy, okay? I'm not the one that came up with all this. I'm sorry. It's made me, I probably am crazy in a way. I mean, I've gone crazy knowing this information. It's all I think about. I have no life. All right, sorry, I'm going back to your calls. It's just, here's the new article, because I wanted to cover that old article. Green Police, DHS launches environmental justice units. And it's Homeland Security, federal enviro cops. And by the way, they're not going to be out at BP when they're dumping stuff in the ocean, or docks and being dumped by Monsanto. No, it's going to be residential. Of course it is. It's the same model in every country. We know exactly what's coming because it's exactly what the globalists have done in England and Australia and Germany. California is moving to ban single occupancy homes from being constructed. This isn't a game. First, it's your toilets and your light bulbs and your weather stripping. All sounds reasonable. Next, it's how many kids you can have. Okay? This isn't a game. I don't know how else I'm supposed to explain this to you. And it's more divide and conquer. This Trayvon Martin thing, the police thing. Let me give a little message to the police out there. The people running this government could care less about you. In fact, they don't like you. They don't like enforcers trained to use force who live in the real world. They want apathetic jellyfish TV heads. That's why the New World Order hates, with a capital H, police and military. I knew this before they released the documents that good police gave me. Federal and state have given me the documents that have been national news over and over again, where they say returning veterans, gun owners, conservatives, libertarians, rural groups, anybody who's self-sufficient. So if they hate farmers because they're self-sufficient, they're natural humans to a certain extent. They're afraid of wild humans, folks. That's how the globalists see us. They say they want us domesticated. Gee, cops, you're part of a macho culture. Most of you didn't join to be bullies. You joined it for excitement, and you want to go after bad guys. I get it. Or you're in the military. You've got an adrenaline fix. You know, you want some excitement. It's a macho culture. I get it. But the point, you like guns? Great. You think they like you? No, they don't like you. The eugenicist, pinhead, control freak scientists hate your motorcycle. They hate your Marine Corps tattoo. They hate your granddaddy who was a farmer. They hate you, okay? So when they have these big spectacles about how important you are, and I see the videos of the police all kind of looking, you know, like, man, this is a big deal they're doing here. It's about using you in a psyop for them. This is not about the Karma-geddon in Austin. This is about propaganda. All right, I'm ranting. Let me ask you this question, Jim. You were making the point as a police officer. Some stations don't carry that first five-minute segment. Instead of me interrupting, make your points. And then I want to ask you about the article that was in the LA Times, Reuters, you name it, 2 days ago. In fact, guys, if you have time, pull it up. IRS bill would ban out-of-country travel or revoke the passport. That's right out of Nazi Germany, Soviet Russia. Doesn't get any more. I told you, currency controls are coming, capital controls. I've seen it in the airport where a guy's got 6 silver coins, and they try to take them and act like it's illegal. Diamond rings they're now asking about. I mean, this is internal checkpoints. That's what the TSA is now fanning out on the highways. This is one of the hallmarks. I mean, if you have a crown jewel, you know, the biggest crown jewel, it's cashless society. You've got to be in good steads to travel. Shutting down swap meets, shutting down people selling strawberries on the side of the road. I mean, you want to live in martial law, this is it. Corporate martial law. As they shut the economy down to bankrupt you so they can consolidate. Okay, I'm ranting. It's just, it's so hardcore. And now the green police and the feds raiding people for hair straighteners. I mean, it's happening. Department of Education raiding people for stuff that isn't even a crime of unpaid tuition. Remember that? And they just said, we're going to start doing it. They're like, but there's no jurisdiction or no code. There's not a law. You don't even have law enforcement power. This isn't even a crime. They go, we don't care. I'm sorry, I'm ranting. Sir, I apologize. It's just, this is why I'm going crazy. What's your take on that, Jim?
Well, first off, I share your frustration. And it doesn't really surprise me about the thing with the IRS and passports. I had heard about this coming up in the past, but just the other day got an email from, I think it was World Net Daily, that was mentioning the bill that was pending. And it's just one more thing where government is legislating away our constitutionally protected rights. You have a right to travel, and no law that's passed by anyone can negate that right, yet they're still doing it. And it would not surprise me to see it pass. Just like in Ohio, we have a thing where if someone's behind on their child support, they can't get a driver's license. Granted, people are giving up their God-given rights in exchange for state-granted privileges every day, just with driving, with concealed carry, and all that kind of stuff. And the big difference here is a passport being withheld. There's, you know, that's still a right to have, and to be able to travel is still a right. But for them to sit here and take that right away without any due process whatsoever, based on an illegal agency saying or alleging that you owe something that you don't owe, it just you know, flies in the face of everything, face that everything is right. But at the same time, it's exactly what I would have expected from this government, because they're, you know, I think they must have meetings every day. What rights can we attack today?
No, that's come out, actually. They want to overthrow our ancient, hard-fought rights that the flag and everything symbolizes. And people think, oh, well, just take my rights. I have nothing to hide. They don't get it. The system wants to literally eat out your substance, as the Declaration of Independence says. And it will destroy the prosperity. Tyrannies make us poor. They're humiliating. And the globalists say they want to make us poor. They say they want to do this to our country. This is horrible. Our country is going in a guillotine right now. And we see all the propaganda, all the pageantry associated with a third world dictatorship being heaped on here. What do you make, and other police officers you talk about, I mean, that you talk to, what do you make and your friends think of the government ordering mobile bulletproof checkpoint systems for the highways, or ordering all these weapons, arming all these agencies? I mean, government is clearly digging in for war with the people. What do they think is going to come out of this, or what's your take on that?
Well, most of the ones I talk to are retired. I retired in 1996, and I have I've got a couple of guys that are still on the job that go to my church, but we haven't discussed this particular instance. But most of the people I talk to are just appalled, and they can't believe that it's actually happening. There's no need for it. There's no justification for it. There's no constitutional support for it. It's just a out-of-control government doing whatever it wants, and the only thing that I think is going to solve the problem, I think, is for the people to stand up and say, no, we're not going to allow this to happen. And I don't have much faith in the election process anymore based on what I've seen over the years. And so it's when the ballot box is unusable, there's only one other box to go to, and we all know what that is. And I hate to say it, but that's, you know, my personal belief at this point. People are just going to have to stand up and fight force with force.
Well, and that's what the system knows, it's going to that. That's why they're getting all ready for war. And I would just tell police and military and everybody else, this is not a fight they want to show up to. Because nobody's going to win except the globalists unless the police and military stand down. and we have that Ceausescu moment, but it's not one guy we've got to arrest. We've got to arrest, and I risk my life saying this, but it's true, the big six bank heads, they've all got to be arrested. I mean, they have engaged in corporate espionage of this country. They've taken us over. We're an occupied country, and now they're moving to shut down our free speech. And you know what Kennedy said about that? Thank you so much. Very cogent call there. Blue, John, Sean, Glenn, I'll get to y'all. And then later I'll try to do a presentation on the Karmageddon, but I've already pretty much covered it. We'll be right back. Stay with us. Several program notes. If you go to Infowars.com, you can see the headline, National Movement Launched to Impeach Obama. It's got the five core reasons why Obama should be impeached. It lists different Congress people that have introduced legislation to begin the impeachment proceeding, and let's get this ball rolling even faster. I will say the video that accompanies it has gone particularly viral. Keep it up, folks. Great job. Coming up after I take some more calls, show folks this headline. And I've saw this case a few weeks ago when it first broke, and I've seen similar cases where they make the autistic kids, now one in 50-something, wear these taser belts. And now they just taser them for any reason. In fact, if you scroll back up, I can read the headline to folks there. It says, tortured, terrorized, and abused. Shocking new video shows disabled boy strapped down and shocked 31 times at school by his own laughing teachers for 7 hours. Well, it's fun to shock and torture people. That's what we're all being taught. We're being taught ugliness and pain of innocence is fun. We're like the Roman Empire, ladies and gentlemen. There's video of them in the restraint, torturing him with enjoyment. The schools are death camp prisons where they administer the vaccines without parental consent all over the country. They take your kids without even a writ, without anything. Just, I mean, that's why I'm freaked out. It's getting so lawless. And when they lose a lawsuit, they just pay with our own tax money. All right, I'm ranting. I wish we could turn this country around. But we're only going to do it by admitting how bad we've gotten, myself included. Blue in Tennessee, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Thank you, Alex. Well, I do believe that we have one other vote besides the ballot, and that is the vote with your dollar. And when I say that, it's an idea that I propose. We need to occupy the media. We need to inundate the media, your local community, with your information. Burn it to a DVD, send it to the station, along with articles. Demand that they start reporting the truth. Have a march on your media. Choose ABC, CBS, NBC, and Fox.
By the way, I agree. Solution-wise, national media gets a little attention, especially if you shoot it yourself, put it on YouTube, so regardless it gets covered, because that's the new dominant media. I mean, soon they're not going to be dominant anymore. In fact, in many cases, they're not. But going to local media, sending them articles, sending them films, bringing up topics you want covered on a weekly basis, it'll start happening with talk radio, and that's how you lobby for freedom, you lobby for real issues to be covered, and you have your voice heard. But you also, then if they don't listen to you, I don't care if it's five of you, go bullhorn the local media. I mean, let them know. Go ahead.
With a sign that just simply says, we know where you work. You live in our community. We're no longer asking for you to tell us the truth. We're demanding that you tell the truth. And then you go and you start contacting the local advertisers and telling them that you will not purchase from them as long as they continue to advertise on this station. Once the advertisers put the pressure on the TV station or the radio station that they're going to pull their ads because they're getting heat from the public, that will put the pressure on the local media to do the right thing.
I agree with you, but expanding on that, take CBS here in Austin. We played the clip probably 200 times. I won't play it today. But you can search it on YouTube. It's Mercury, good for children's brains, and it'll come up. But this was a package produced at CBS Broadcast Center in Manhattan, and then they send the video down the feed, and then the local voices it. Most of your news that's not local, you know, that you see, is a local face, but they didn't write it. That's the teleprompter control. And my point is, this just didn't air in Austin. It aired on every CBS affiliate in the country that decided to go with that package they were sent. They don't have to go with it, but they had sent to them. So it aired on most of them, and it said mercury is good for children's brains and helps them behave themselves. And in a sick way, that's true. The globalists think your brain is good when there's rot holes in it and your brain damaged. So for them, it said it's good for your brain. Well, for them, it's good. You know, for Charlie Manson, cutting babies out of women is a good thing. I mean, it doesn't mean it's good for normal people. But for Charlie Manson, that's a good day. So see, it's all from there. It's all little sick games. But my issue is that local news director should have gone, mercury's good for kids' brains. No, we're not running this. They've also got some contracts with stations where it's must air, especially if it's owned by CBS, but most are, I mean, the point is it's all the major channels. Anything else, ma'am?
Yes. Another thing that and their local communities need to do, I did this myself personally. I saw some anomalies in the voting here in Tennessee, and so I actually made an appointment and went to the election commission to look at all 92 polling tapes from the night.
Stay there. I want to hear the rest of this. By the way, I forgot to tell you, our reporters got harassed in Georgia. Yeah, this song's about Eric Holder. She knows how to use her legs down at Oklahoma City and shipping those guns into Mexico. And then she runs on those legs to then use that as an excuse to try to ban semi-auto handguns and rifles. And then Holder ran on over to an Al Sharpton meeting with those legs. And, you know, thank Sharpton for the great work he's done yesterday trying to get a race war going. Meanwhile, where are folks for this black kid chained down and shocked 31 times in a restraint begging for no reason as the teachers laugh over 7 hours? That's what these schools now are, dungeons. And there's so many kids damaged. These kids are so damaged. And there's so many of them now in special ed that they're having to build giant facilities everywhere. I mean, soon an Olympic athlete will be somebody who can brush their teeth or tie their shoelaces under the genetic, chemical, biological warfare attack that we're under. There it is. Tortured, terrorized, and abused. Shocking new video shows a disabled boy strapped down and shocked 31 times at a school by his own laughing teachers for 7 hours. Staff at the Judge Rottenberg Center pumped electricity through Andre McCollin's body 31 times because he would not take his coat off. He was left in a coma for 3 days caused by the shock. Of course, you're not going to see Al Sharpton. And by the way, that kid does look like Obama's son. That looks just like Obama. Oh, but the government did that. The government did that, so that's okay. By the way, they've trained police for at least 30 years in big cities, pain compliance. And I've shown the video of pro-lifers having their arms broken. The cops tell them, get up, I'm not going to carry you. All right, get the nunchucks. Boom! Break that arm. Let me tell you, you get a compound fracture like that set, surgery, you could die in surgery, infection. That is assault with a deadly weapon. Hardcore assault. Premeditated. And again, you're like, what are you, anti-cops? I'm anti... See how that's mindless? Are you anti-police? What does that mean? Yeah, I'm against the criminal government ordering police to break people's arms, whether I agree with their politics or not. I mean, that's tyranny, man. That's North Korea. In North Korea, if you're not in good standing, they take your passport. You can't travel. It's past the Senate. It's in the House that if they just open a file on you and say you're under investigation, you're not convicted of tax evasion. And I mean, murderers who've gotten out of jail are allowed to travel. That's a right, folks. This is an internal passport. Remember when they said if your state doesn't take the national ID, you won't be allowed to travel into federal buildings, state parks, or across state lines? Remember that? And Ron Paul and others warned people? I cannot even describe to you, I use this word a lot, the magnitude, the magnitude of how much trouble. I just got chills. Folks, we're in a lot of trouble. Do you know where this road leaves? These are really bad people. They don't want to just rob and be boss hogs and in charge. They want total control over your reproductive system, over your land, over your family. You know, take this new thing. In fact, you can show a photo of Mitt Romney's family if you want. Mitt Romney's got five sons. What is it, 30-something grandkids? I mean, I forget. It's some giant number. 16 grandkids, I forget. And they have this Democratic consultant, top consultant, saying that she never worked a day in her life. You can just search the photo, the entire family. And I'm not, this is even about Mitt Romney, the globalist, you know, the big banker. The point is that here's a woman with five sons, and she said, I chose to stay home with my family. That was my job. And the media and Miss Magazine that was run by the CIA back in the 60s said, women, you're scum if you're at home. She'll go out and get a job so your kids can be at school full time so the state can be the mommy and the daddy. And now our families have broken up. Society is degenerated in every metric. People are not anywhere as happy as they were in the 50s and 60s. People work longer hours. Women are treated like absolute trash. But they implied women didn't have value if they raised their children. Well, you know what? Most women didn't raise their children because they wrecked the society. Once you get most of the women wanting to work, now everybody's got to pay taxes. The prices change. It killed the old economy we had. And so now, yeah, that's an earlier photo. There's a new one. I saw it all over the news today. It's just everywhere. Just type in Romney family. They're all wearing blue striped shirts. It doesn't matter. You know, the TV part of this show is such a small part. And then it ends up dominating everything because I'm always over there looking at it and wanting to document everything for people that are watching on prisonplanet.tv. You know, the nightly news, it's all about TV and TV only. And we sit here on the fly, you know, showing people the information. You know, and sometimes it, you know, causes hiccups here. But, you know, my point is that it's good, though, because even though the TV audience is a fraction of the millions of radio listeners, it creates a documented record of everything I'm talking about. So that's a good aspect or dimension to what we do here on air. Now, getting back to this Mitt Romney situation, America's woken up to a great extent. America overall is becoming more libertarian, more constitutional, more mistrustful of government than it's been in its entire history since our founding. All the studies and polls show that. 9% approval rating for Congress. Abortion is now overwhelmingly unpopular. In fact, the numbers have basically flipped. Depending on which study you look at, it's roughly 60-something percent were for abortion when they did Roe v. Wade, being told it was just a blob and wasn't human, and the media was able to sell that with the trust they still had. Now it's 65-70% against abortion, and with young people, I've seen numbers of over 90%. So the globalists are desperate to get all this through right now because they're control freaks, and they hate humanity, they hate life, and they hate you openly, and they hate our industrial society. So they poison us while posing as the saviors all day. That's the look at who's saying they're the hero, folks, in the system, and then look at actually what they're doing. Investigate. That's all I'm saying is investigate. Investigate me. Investigate false claims against us. You know, really investigate. So you find out 99% of stuff is not true about me. Investigate others, though, and investigate yourself. It's so important. And just don't be so trusting and get your common sense back. Or if you never had it, go read what the Founding Fathers wrote. Go discover common sense because common sense is reemerging right now and the system doesn't like it. But because, you know, 30 years ago when the CIA on record, this is now declassified, hired Gloria Steinem to have Miss Magazine, they put her on all the shows telling women, your husband's a pig, he's a piece of garbage, he hates you, he's suppressing you, he's dominating you. You know, you're going to be happy when you're wearing the pants. You know, make your son sit on the toilet. Women should be in frontline combat. You know, men are trash. And women, are you happy now? Do you like what you got? It's cold social engineering to literally destroy the family, and California is set to pass a law banning new construction of single-family homes, just like Germany has now done. You're like, well, that's crazy. That's tyranny. Yeah, it moves real quick. It takes a while to grow. It's kind of like a 14-year-old. People made jokes four or five years ago when the New York Times came out and said, you know, they're training Boy Scouts to take on disgruntled vets and kill them. And it showed photos of it. I'd already told you that was going on. People didn't believe it, but there it was. Oh, it's wonderful. Scouts trained to fight terror and more. Main mission, killing veterans that won't turn their guns in. First paragraph of the article. People made jokes. Oh, I'd kill those 14-year-olds. Oh, really? You would? You think so? Those 14-year-olds are now 18. The best soldiers are 18 to 20 years old. Because they're mean, they're young, and they think they're bulletproof. Like a lot of militaries would send 12-year-olds into the particularly deadly missions. Because they have fun doing it. I mean, I remember when I was 13, I was vicious. Because I was coming into my manhood and all the synapses were firing. And I was put in positions to be able to explore that, and I loved it. The exhilaration. It's the same thing with tyranny. People are like, oh, that little thing, that's not now, it's big. It's big now. And folks, it's growing fast. It is shedding its skin into the final phase. All right, I got to go to your calls. It's just that they come out now and they say, how pathetic. She never worked a day in her life. Can't believe she's a stay-at-home mom. What a piece of filth, basically. That doesn't work anymore, does it? You know what all these women do who want to be executives? All of them that I've seen. They go out. They're 40 years old. They got the power. They got boy toys, everything. They want a man. They want kids. And then they want to dominate the man still, but then they're not happy in that. And it's not just women. I'm not bashing women. Women and men make the species. We're literally joined. Just like the egg and the sperm join and make the zygote. And then all those calculations. That's magic, ladies and gentlemen. We're the dominant species on this gorgeous planet together. We are humanity. There is no man or woman. And the system wages war against that. Are there things that men do? Yeah, men dominate each other and kill each other. But the point is that we look at this attack. This is an attack on women. This wasn't done to empower women. It's like Edward Bernays put ads in newspapers and paid all the top feminists to smoke cigarettes in newsreels and in radio interviews and prints and to call it liberty. Liberty smokes. They knew it caused lung cancer. To march with the cigarettes lit. And all the women ran out and got their cigarettes. How sexy was it when your grandma was all hooked up to those tubes as they were cutting organs out of her from the cigarettes a few years ago? How sexy is Edward Bernays now and Gloria Steinem? Gloria Steinem, well, she's got a bunch of kids and a man. She likes putting her arm in her husband's arm and walking a step behind him. Women like that. On average, women that are happy. And it's, I mean, you ever seen deer? A doe will walk a little bit off behind the buck. Whales do that. It's what mammals do. It's what we do. Women want the smart, dynamic, powerful man. But the media says that they want some little boy toy who's metrosexual and does what he's told. No, that's not what women are looking for. Okay? And so the media puts out this image to the young men. I see the young men imitating it. Act metrosexual, act weak, act stupid, act dumb, act foolish, act like a sitcom character, and you're going to get all the babes. And the guys don't get the babes. It's a subconscious thing. They're not even conscious, most of them. So they act stupider. They act weaker. They act dumber. They act noncommittal. They watch more sports. They wear more baseball caps. They act more arrested. And man, that's not what women are looking for. You're a man on a mission who's got things going on. You're thinking about things and you're not thinking about the skirts. The skirts don't even have to know who you are. They immediately beeline straight at you. And I'm just trying to talk to the men out there. And the feminists would say, don't call women skirts. Well, my goodness, my goddess, whatever. It's a power game. Women want to look good and want to have that power, but they don't want you to point it out. It's all just games. Stop playing the games, women and men. Be the humans you are. Be powerful. Build each other up. So this attempts, oh, you threw the old, oh, it's pathetic, she raised five boys and all these grandchildren, and that's the most important job there is. You notice it hadn't been getting done. And it's not just by the women. The men are more to blame in this country for buying into being absent, buying into the gangster culture that it's cool to get women pregnant and then sit back and laugh. That old gangster culture came when the government said, how do we kill these black people and how do we break them down? They got their own businesses. They got their own universities. They're really getting strong. They said, pose as their friends. Give them a Trojan horse, a gift. Tell the women you get money, don't have a man in the house. Then create enmity with others who aren't on welfare, pointing it out. And watch these people and the family disappear. And they've gone to almost, what is it, 90%+ illegitimacy from 20, 30, 40%. Whites are now following the same line. Everybody else is. They are turning us into mindless jellyfish who don't grow up seeing their dad work hard and be strong and do things that are right. That's what they've done to us. And where mama's not there, the kids are, you know, get home at 6, mama goes, makes dinner, daddy makes dinner, pizza comes, whatever, do some laundry, mama's exhausted, because it's an unnatural life. It's stressful enough with 3 or 4 kids at home having to run everything and having to get everything in order and trying, you know, or to have a little business on the side. That's what women have always traditionally done. But that culture's all gone. You know, where daddy gives mama the paycheck and she handles the banking and runs the house and mama's the strength of the house and daddy goes out in the world, it's all gone. And what's left of it's being mopped up. And people now, as they see freedom and everything good going down the drain, they're reaching back going, oh, maybe that isn't so bad. Oh, see, it's, you don't know what you got till it's gone. Oh, I sold everything out for Gloria Steinem and the CIA. Wait, no. And see, you're going to look back on the freedoms we had now and go, no, I want that back. And it's going to be 10 times harder to get. And that's what's sad. I just see, like, you ever watch somebody bleed to death? I've seen somebody bleed to death when the ambulance was getting there from a car wreck. They died by the time they got in the ambulance. They're pretty much gone. And the blood's coming out, and people are trying to put something on it, and you see them, they're still alive. They got the fire of humanity in their eyes, and then you see them. It's not just that they're passing out. You know, you see them, and they're like, and you see them fighting. You know, the body knows it's in trouble. And they're like, and then the adrenaline hits. They're okay for a while, and then it's kind of, and then they're gone. They're dead already. And I'm just watching America. The blood's like, was gushing, you know, shooting out. People freak out over little stuff, but, you know, but still it wasn't that bad. And now it's just kind of like, yeah, the TSA grubs our daughters. Oh, yeah, more of them got busted today, pedophiling people. That's 2 days in a row. It's just like, well, yeah, they're pedophiles. Yeah, they clearly single out good-looking women and children. You know, some like to perv women, some like to perv men, others like to perv on children. And he's like, well, that's what we do to fight the terrorists. We let potbelly pervs grab our children's genitals. All right, I'll go back to your calls. But I think that was important to say. We'll be back. All right, let's try to get back to your phone calls. I am long-winded, but it's important information. By the way, we do have our reporters, Darrin McBreen and Marcos Morales, coming on. They went to the city outside Atlanta where the man was killed because they were basically buying up the property in an area to make it a green space for a 1021, and his little piece of property was the last piece. So they harassed him to not have chickens anymore, even though he'd been there for a long time and it was grandfathered. It was on the edge of the town. And his house blew up and he's dead after having his chickens killed. And by somebody, and the people just want us to say we shouldn't investigate, and the police came and said, get out of the city hall, and we said, well, we're just here filming and, you know, here to talk to people, and they said, no, you have to have an appointment to come in city hall. So that's the new America. So that's coming up with our reporters on that subject here in just a moment. Real quick, finishing up with Blue in Tennessee, then I got to go to John and KJ and Sean. Well, he's been home the longest. Glenn will be after Blue, and then John. Blue, go ahead and finish your story. You said you went and tried to document some election fraud in Tennessee, and what happened to you?
Well, I actually made an appointment at the Election Commission to look at review all 92 poll tapes from the night of the election. And upon arrival, they printed out a 1,000-page document for me to review. They would not allow me to look at the poll tapes. And they tried to intimidate me, putting me in a room with three very large men.
Well, that's standard procedure. That's the freedom of America. Because again, if people knew the criminality in government, it would make their head spin. It's a big business. And they're robbing us, and they're not going to stop. And they're going to raise the property taxes, and they're going to take our property and then move into it and exempt themselves. That's a new thing they're doing. And they're not going to let us travel, and we're their slaves. I appreciate your call. Until we decide we don't want to be. We're back where our forebears were in 1776. John in Wyoming, you're on the air. Thanks for holding.
Yeah, Alex, a couple of quick items. First of all, they showed on, I'm in Sheridan, Wyoming, and we get cable out of Rapid City, South Dakota, as well as Casper, Wyoming. And one of the Rapid City stations showed their SWAT team and hostage rescue team conducting exercises, you know, getting prepared for something. And then the Casper station showed the Cheyenne, Wyoming Police Department doing the same thing. So something is, I think, brewing here. Also, let's discuss briefly, if you don't mind, what you and I talked about on George Norrie's program back on the morning of March 20th, that a year ago the NRA and the American Rifleman published a notice that Homeland Security had contracted with Winchester to purchase 200 million rounds of 40 Smith & Wesson ammo.
And now they just bought 450 more million.
Now another 450 million from ATK, which is the parent company of Federal Cartridge Corporation of Minnesota and Spear CCI of Lewiston, Idaho. So 650 million rounds of 40 Smith & Wesson, which is what all the federal agencies carry, U.S. Marshals, FBI, CIA, Customs, Border Patrol, all of them. And I'm wondering, that's more than two rounds for every man, woman, and child in the United States. Gee, I wonder what they're planning to do with all of that ammunition.
Well, all now, I can tell them is good luck, because just because they can, you know, tell the public to all stand out for a dead police officer, which I think is fine, and you know, the public shows up because they're good people, the system gets much more tyrannical and starts physical fights. I would not want to be one of the minions of the system. I mean, this is the chutzpah-filled, bravada-filled New World Order that makes 40-to-1 bets at MF Global with other people's bank accounts. I mean, the bankers set offshore, and they're incredibly arrogant, and they've bitten off more than they can chew. What do you think's going on?
Yeah, well, they're getting ready to do to do something, because the reason why I think the national media is trying to precipitate a race war here with this Trayvon Martin case is so Obama can declare martial law and then start picking up the firearms.
Oh, bingo. They're looking at doing it. All right. We are now into hour number three. We're going to have some of our reporters coming up here in about 10 minutes or so from Roswell, Georgia, where they went to investigate the mysterious death of a man who had been harassed because they wanted his property as part of a green space zone, part of Agenda 21, over by Rob Dew's house here in Austin. FEMA made people tear down all their nice houses, turn it into a green zone that no one's allowed onto. It's just a raw exercise of power. That's what the government does. Hey, we're going to stick our hands down your child's pants, we're going to grope your wife right in front of you, and we're going to radiate you, and how do you like it? Just the bankers are like, listen, you're our cattle, get used to it. And, you know, the last caller was bringing up all the hundreds of thousands of weapons the government's bought and the hundreds of millions of rounds they're buying to use against the American people and all the other things they're doing. The government's buying bulletproof checkpoints that are mobile. I mean, this is a full-on armament system, like when Germany was arming before World War II or other systems. It's a huge arms build up, trainings build up for the American people with spies and tattletale squads and mobile prisons and checkpoints. And they're always going, it's for Al-Qaeda, it's for Al-Qaeda. And you look, it's not, it's for us. The government was taken over by foreign banks. I don't know how else I can explain it. And it's not like the police and military, they're going to be asked to carry this out, are going to be winners in it. You're going to be carrying out the wrecking of America so it can be consolidated into the North American Union. You're going to be, it's the equivalent of a cop, you know, being on board a bass boat with you, and it's their bass boat and your bass boat, you co-own it, and the cop shoots it with a shotgun and blows a hole in the bottom, and it's sinking, and he says, I'm sinking your boat, ha, ha, ha. And you're like, Bob, it's your boat too, man. What's the, you see that? Glenn in Maryland, thanks for holding her on the air.
Hi, Alex. First time caller, long time listener. How are you?
I'm all right. It's just things are getting crazy. It's all...
Yeah, it's getting really crazy. Listen, I just want to make a few quick comments. On this police parade yesterday, it wasn't only a power grab, but it also sets the precedent for it to happen in other states. If it had happened in a city like Dallas or something, I would say, ooh, it's a movie set. They're going to rob the Federal Reserve, and then say it happened during the police parade. The second issue I wanted to bring up was when this Trayvon shooting occurred, the first thing I said, they're going to use this for gun control grab and then try to turn it into race war. And sure enough, 2 days later, they tried to turn it into a race war and the gun grabs. My last point was I was doing some investigative journalism last year concerning some of the government black ops projects and how they led up to where we were, where we are today. About 9 o'clock at night, I get a phone call, and they ask for a gentleman. I said, no, nobody lives here by that name. They say, is this MK Ultra and Associates? I says, no, this is a private home. He says, well, do they have a name? And they ran off another couple of names. It wasn't until I hung up the phone that I realized what this phone call was all about. I did a star 69. The call could not be called back. And it led to my suspicions that I was onto something and they were attempting to intimidate me by using keywords that they knew I would catch on.
No, exactly. That is exactly what feds or private contractors will do. They don't like, you must have gotten close to something big. Stay there. I want to come back and finish up your story. I mean, I've been sitting there in front of my crew and a number doesn't even show up. My cell phone rings. And they say things to me, or they do it to my wife. And that's the exact type of stuff they do right there. We'll be right back. We are back live, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining us. I'm here Monday through Friday, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central, 12 noon to 3 p.m. Eastern. Back Sundays, 4 to 6 p.m. I'll be live this Sunday. Wasn't live, of course, for Easter. And then we have Infowars Nightly News, 5 nights a week, 7 o'clock. I never really got into my full breakdown of Karma-geddon, but I'm going to just succinctly at the bottom of the hour get into it and draw some parallels of things and why I'm upset about it, and then continue into some of the other news. We have our reporters via video Skype from in front of the home of Andrew Wirtis, who had his property seized and was terrorized to death in the city of Roswell, Georgia, and the police told him, well, they've been photographed. The police have told him they're basically watching him. And they were told, get out of the city council building. You're not welcome here. And the cops added, sorry, we're just doing our jobs and what we were told. Can I rob a bank? Like have somebody tell me, hey, Alex, go rob a bank. Oh, okay. And the cops get there and go, oh, I was told to rob the bank. It's okay then. Or maybe carry a hand grenade on an airplane. Maybe you should. I'm not saying actually try it, folks, but, you know, my neighbor said I could carry a hand grenade on the airplane. Is that all right? I was just following orders, so it's okay. The road to hellish perdition and deviltry is paved with people following orders. And look, even though I'm Mr. Antony World Order, I catch myself all the time if I'm tired or got something else I want to do, that I'll just kind of put up with something. Not anymore, though. I don't care. I just cannot put up with any of it anymore. Okay, we were just talking to a gentleman, Glenn, in Maryland, and he was raising his points about the Trayvon Martin thing, saying day one, he thought it was going to be used to create racial division, racial paranoia on all different sides, so the referee of the government can divide and conquer and play the part of the savior. And then he was getting into being an investigative journalist, the caller said he was doing some investigation, and got this phone call saying, yeah, is this MK Ultra? Yeah, is this? That's exactly the kind of stuff the feds or contractors do. I've gotten those calls. Yeah, I was, in fact, I think I've even gotten one of those calls. Yeah, I was calling about the MK Ultra New World Order. Yeah, of course, this is an unlisted number at the time, the times it's happened. And then, by the way, that little white dog in your backyard, that's real nice. Oh, yeah, running back and forth in front of the sliding glass door. This actually happened to my wife one time. Similar things happened to me. He's like, I'm going to get you and cut your head off, you know, because they'll try to, or the favorite one is women calling your wife and saying, hi, is Alex there? No, he's not. Can I leave a message? You know, they know a woman's going to ask, well, can I get a message? Who is this? Oh, never mind. I'll just tell him when I see him. What do you mean when you see him? Who are you? Well, okay, who's this? Well, I'm his wife. Well, that's him. What? That's impossible. We're engaged to be married. We're engaged to be married. And then my wife's like, oh, this is a prank call, and hangs up. She's gotten them, I don't know, quite a few times. And the point is, the number won't even show up on caller ID. And then they'll say, I hope your mother dies, or I hope your dad is in the hospital dies, you blah. I mean, so they're listening on the phone. Because multiple times I've had it happen, my wife's had it happen. Imagine, I'm there protesting Bilderberg. Bilderberg's ended, it's full of NSA, all this spy gear. I've walked into the gift shop right before they shut the hotel down, the day they were arriving that morning, and the door opened. To use a Star Wars analogy, I was like C-3PO in Cloud City, you know, going in the wrong room. He's like, oh, wait, oh, stormtroopers, no. Anyways, the door's right there. They're going, I'm telling you, you dial into the Navy and Air Force satellite with a CMQX fiber. All right, whatever, but I'm telling you, this system, wait, I've got them. They're moving now. You got to get that other dignitary on there. Oh, wait, the ambassador. Yeah, we got it. Patch it into upstairs. And they had like every conceivable area with just spy gear everywhere. They had the conference rooms being loaded with it. There were all these military guys in plain clothes everywhere. And I'm sitting there for like 10 minutes getting my Gatorade. Because the cooler was right there. Okay, my guys are on Skype. I got to go to them. I'm out of control. The point is, I've just seen so much crazy stuff. And they're arguing with each other about, No. You got to break into his cell phone with this satellite. And I'm listening to it. What's it got on there? He's got a Nokia. All right, well, I'm telling you, it's on this system. You got to use this satellite. And I'm just listening to them, spying on people illegally right there. And after a while, they figured it out and got up and slammed the door. But I mean, they're just so used to the zombie, but that's a side issue. The reason I got off into that story is it had all broken up. We're at the steakhouse. Aaron Dykes was there. And my wife's like, oh, my dad, or was it her mama? No, it was her dad at the time. They'd both been ill at the time. He's in the hospital. He's, you know, it's real bad. They're doing surgery. My daddy, I'm worried about him. When are you coming home? Like, we're eating a steak. We're flying out in about 3 hours. It was, you know, great mission. A lot of great footage. We're going to expose these guys. All right, love you. I'll see you tonight. Do you need me to pick you up? You know, no, baby, I don't. Bye. Hang up. They passed the A1 sauce, calls back crying, and they called up and did the whole thing and then said they hope her dad dies and all this stuff. You know, was that the call where they said she was pregnant? Or they also called up and say, I've given women diseases. That's another one. That's another angry woman calls up about the disease. And it's just all to mess with your family. It's like right out of the film JFK. Those are true stories, what happened to Garrison. And if they get your kid on the phone, too, if they get your kid to answer the phone, they'll try to creep them out. Because these are cowardly, un-American, anti-human scum who've sold out to the bankers. And they think it's funny to call up and make fun of somebody's dad who's in the hospital. Okay, enough from me. I got to go to McBreen. He just dropped. I was going to go back to him. The guy had a great voice, too. I wanted to talk to him some more. Listen, Sam, we're going to leave that line open. If you can get back in, I guess I confused him saying I was going to McBreen. If you can get back in, it'll fill up constantly. It's already full. You can get back in. I want to hear the rest of your story. But he told the story about how he was doing some investigative work and they would call up and do that. And yes, that's how it works. And if it intimidates you, next they're going to beat you up in your parking lot. But if you just say, hey, you know what? I got my back turned. Do whatever you're going to do, coward. I don't want to die, but go ahead and make me a martyr. But don't let me see you coming. Enjoy the cancer viruses. Take extra shots. I start saying, how many of your family members have got neurological disorders? I bet the evil work you do, you've been judged. You got sick kids? You wonder why your life's so miserable? Why don't you join the good guys? Oh, they don't like that. It takes the fun out. Okay, I'm sorry. Let's talk to... let me just reset here. Because I'm joking around here, and the news we've got to cover here demands serious import, serious gravitas, serious reverence and focus. I want to respect this issue to simplify it. State seizes property under green zoning laws, terrorizes man to death. We didn't hear the story until he died, and we've got our crew there on the ground with a live video feed of the burnout little farmhouse. They'd already been grabbing the land up to it for a UN biological diversity zone, which they, of course, later would build on, undoubtedly. That's how it works. They'd harassed him since 08. He kept winning over and over and over again that he was allowed to have chickens because it was on the edge of the town and grandfathered. And they weren't going to put up with that, so they came to take the property, and it blew up. And you can see blast holes in the top of the house. And the government wants us to just out of the gates within 5 minutes. No foul play. He killed himself. That's the way it is. So if somebody comes to my house and blows it up, I want an investigation. Okay, I'm not blowing my house up. If somebody says I slip and fall, you know, break my head open, I want an investigation. If I'm found dead in a hotel room with a hooker with a heroin needle in my arm, don't use drugs. Don't use hookers. Okay. I just want to say I'm not going to commit suicide either. But they won. They've got their green zone now. Of course, now they're just saying they may just sell it and the city may do something with it now. Oh, not going to be a green zone now, I guess. That's the latest. Darrin McBreen and Marcos Morales reporting from the ground. They're in Roswell, Georgia, where the tyrants have landed. They're not little green men. They're little bureaucrats with armed police defending them so they can carry out their operations. Another victory. On the homeland front against a wicked man for many, many years, raising a few chickens in his backyard. But he's been dealt with. Darrin McBreen, you're there at the site of the evil chicken man, as the police call him. Thank you for joining us.
Yeah, actually, Alex, the entire community calls him the chicken man, but lovingly. He's very popular in the area.
Well, he's dead now. He's dead, though.
He's known for raising chickens.
Well, he's dead now. So please continue. So they've had a victory. Tell us what happened.
Well, he tragically died on March 26th following an explosion that took place right here at his home. And this was during when, you know, the county marshals were here to forcibly evict him from his property. And this was to enforce the new green zoning laws. And he did not comply, but, you know, the whole history of this thing goes back a few years. They harassed him from the very beginning when it was obviously apparent to the city council and the state of Georgia that he did not want to budge. And so they began by giving him citations for owning too many chickens. It escalated. He got citations for grading his own property with a tractor that he borrowed from the mayor of Roswell, Georgia. But he got signed for that as well. And eventually he got thrown in jail for basically grading property with a tractor, if you can believe that.
Amazing. I want to come back and tell us what happened to you with the police, what the locals are saying. Now, you've talked to some journalists. We're investigating what happened. We can see the house that looks like it was in World War II with blast holes in the roof. It looks like the explosion did come from within, from what I'm looking at. And so we'll get more with investigative journalists there on the ground, Marcos Morales and Darrin McBreen, straight ahead. And then I will break down the... Look, it's not fun getting in the way of Arde Saveda and this giant event they had. Next, I guess, when their poor police officer gets killed, they're going to, like, I guess for 7 days straight, rout a giant... cavalcade in circles, and then all of us should bloodlet to say we're sorry. another report from on the ground tomorrow with Darrin McBreen. They're going to be finally more detailed reports and higher res video they're going to be uploading. We should have the nightly news tonight and tomorrow night and next week. Because this is a big deal. More and more, they're killing people. People end up dying who don't vaccinate their kids, even though there's no law, or people that don't, you know, hand over their property, or people that sell milk to their neighbors. Government is a mafia now to make sure no other business operates but what they want. And it turned out a bunch of people were keeping chickens. It was very popular. It's a semi-rural area. What changed with the chicken man and the person that's now dead? And tell us what you've learned about his death. I mean, is it leaning towards a suicide that they drove him to his death, or is there foul play? Tell us what the police did, Darrin, when you were there.
Well, we haven't seen any, you know, signs or heard anything about, you know, foul play. You know, it is very suspicious, though. There has been a police presence here since we got here. When we showed up at the property this morning, you know, a police car drove by, slowed down, took a look at us. We didn't think too much about it until we went to City Hall. And we simply just attempted to walk in there. You know, Marcos first went inside to see, you know, if we're at the right place and if we could talk to someone from the city council. Well, the media spokesperson pretty much told him that he wasn't allowed in. Marcos came out, told me that, and I said, well, you know what, let's grab the camera, let's go in there. By the time we grabbed the camera, a cop pulls up, immediately says, you know, you are not allowed to enter, turn your cameras off, which we refused to do so, and the next thing you know, we're surrounded by two other police officers.
So on the street in America, you don't have a camera. You better watch it. In places like Illinois, life in prison for filming police. There's no law, but they got juries that will send a ham sandwich to the gas chamber. So first they said, you don't have your, you don't have cameras in America. Okay.
Well, yeah, and we naturally schooled the police officers on our, you know, on our rights, you know, that we refused to turn the cameras off, said, look, you're a public servant, you know, we're going to videotape if we want to, and by the way, you have your dash cam running, so we're going to keep our cameras rolling. What do you think of that? So we had this exchange for a while. They demanded that they see our credentials, what and that's ridiculous, you know, because...
Yeah, like you've got to be with ABC or CBS,
oh,
but,
yeah,
it,
we must be
but
with
it doesn't
Fox
matter.
News,
they always
yeah.
act like credentials or your... That's what the state police called our local AM affiliate, 590, and kept calling random people trying to get somebody to say I didn't work there and that I was dishonest. One time when they said, where are you on the radio? And we said, well, locally 590. So that they could then put in a file, we've now learned, that we masquerade. We're not media, and we're not on 590 in the state police file. Because I've talked to folks internally. That's what that was. Because they say so. Their file says we're not on the radio, Darrin.
Well, you know, and I explained to them that City Hall in Austin, Texas, where we are from, that we're able to walk up the steps with a camera. So is the average citizen. And but they flat out refused to let us in. They did give us a phone number of someone we could call. You know, basically gave us a runaround.
Did you ask him what the law was that media or random citizens traveling through cannot enter? Obviously, a public building. Was it marked that it's not public?
No, absolutely not.
And yeah. Well, listen. This is pure color of law. They're acting very suspicious. You got a dead guy, and they don't want to talk to you. And the police are trying to violate your First Amendment and your right for a redress of grievances to go in a public building. This, I mean, just sounds pretty bad, Darrin.
Well, and interestingly enough, when the police officers left, it wasn't but a few minutes later that, and we got this on video, a family showed up. They walked up the steps and began taking pictures. And no one came out and told them they couldn't do otherwise. And the cop, there's a cop car sitting right there watching them do it. So right after we weren't allowed to go in, a family shows up and gets their pictures taken in front of City Hall.
Well, I'm not telling you to go in there, but if they tried to arrest you for disorderly conduct or whatever, you'd have a major lawsuit. And we are suing Pittsburgh right now over dues arrest. I'm not telling you guys to go get arrested, but I think if I was there, I probably would have just gone in.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, those guys are just out of their jurisdiction. I mean, they are violating your rights.
They basically barricaded us with three cop cars to block our entrance, and we were quite a few, what do you say, Marcos, a football field away from the stairs, you know. They stopped us, man. I mean, as soon as we started making the move to go towards those steps, they pulled up, one cop first, and then the next two were quickly followed, and they were not going to have it.
Yeah, that's called tyranny. Does Marcos want to say anything?
Marcos, you want to add to it? Marcos is really good, by the way. He would not turn that camera off, and he knows his rights.
No, you guys did a great job. I just can't believe what tyrants these guys are. And
no, I was very surprised.
That was like when the Federal Reserve was a half mile away from their own building. We're at a park.
And we're sharing earpieces here.
We're coming right back to you, Marcos. We're going to break. And security guards walk over and go, leave, give us your ID. And they start pulling the guns out. And it was like, leave or I'm going to... And it's just like, well, you're not even... You're a security guard. You're not even on your property. And you know, the guys left because it's just, this country's gone, man. Well, Andrew Wardis is dead. A couple days ago, the police came to take him out of his house, said he was taking it, and it blew up. And they're currently Marcos Morales joining us, and also Darrin McBreen there in Roswell, Georgia, where you're not allowed to get near the city council building and not allowed to enter. There's no law, but they got guns. It's called tyranny. Kind of like where the police chief fired the mayor and everybody out in courtside and declared himself supreme ruler. I mean, and he's still there. The state government said, you bet. I'm telling you, this country is turning into a nightmare, and I just want to try to reverse all this and recognize it's only going to get worse. It's not going to get better. These people are out of control. So it looks bad. I was hoping that when you guys went that they would be forthcoming and open, at least wouldn't try to bully you, even if they refuse an interview. But it looks bad, and I know you guys are staying in the town. I want to tell you guys to not stay there tonight. And to just get out of that town as soon as you're done with your interviews, because heaven knows what they'll do to you. The signs we've already seen, it doesn't look good, and I don't want to get you guys, you know, with drugs planted on you or something, so you probably need to get out of there. That's a boss hog town. Do they seem emboldened, Marcos? Are they going to start putting, kind of like fighter pilots put how many planes they've shot down? I remember seeing a tank with how many citizens they'd killed. That the feds had on a tank for here in America. So, I mean, what's your overall view on what's happening there? What else has unfolded?
Well, whenever I noticed that I mentioned to the media relations person in City Hall, I first walked in just to make sure we were in the right place, because there was two buildings adjacent to each other. So I walk in the first one, and I see the city council members' names on the wall. So I start asking around if there's any elected officials in the building that would be willing to talk to the media. And I got ushered immediately to the media relations lady, and the first thing she asked me is, who was I with? And I said, we were traveling... traveling reporters from Austin. We report with KLBJ, which is our go-to affiliate. And the second I told them that we were talking about green conservation areas, the lady started ushering me towards the door. The moment I dropped the subject matter, because she pushed me about three times before I answered her, and the second I said that, she started pushing me towards the door, didn't touch me, but ushering me, walking me, and just opened the door and quit talking to me, essentially, and told me that I should check the website for events and times when officials would be in the building. So I walked out the door and brought the information to Darrin and said, nobody's here, nobody wants to talk to us, but, you know, there's...
Notice she's an official, not a servant. She's a queenie, and a queenie can have the police tell you that you're not allowed in the city council building, the public building, where, I mean, you might want to go in there and conduct public business. With all the different little miscreant agencies. But no, you're the evil press, and she showed you. Continue.
The official showed me out. I go and get Darrin, and I tell him there's good B-roll in there, and we should go in there and get it. And Darrin said, yes, let's get in there. Let's get some footage. Maybe we can talk to that lady when we get in there. So we turn around, grab the camera, and the second we left the car, the cops pulled up. He was rolling by about 5 miles an hour, saw that we pulled the camera out of the car, and zoomed up, probably sped up to about 25, 30 miles an hour, hit the brakes hard, and started chastising us. What are you guys doing here? Who are you? And walked right out of the car, and he started telling us to shut down the camera, and I reminded him that he was a public servant. I told him, I said, you are a public servant on public property. we have every right to be here and film. And he repeatedly tried to shut the camera down. And Darrin kept yelling at me, make sure that camera's rolling. Make sure it's rolling. Right in front of the cops. So we got shut down immediately. I figured the media relations person would be the one willing to talk to us and wanted to talk to
us. Here's what you should do. I would go back and make the whole issue of the tyranny. And when the police come back up, of course, they're going to follow you. And when they're following you, I'd pull over and stop and ask them, you know, what's going on. And then, you know, basically record it. And then I would start walking up towards it when they come say, well, that's not a public building. What's the law, officer? So you're involved in color of law. You're involved in obstructing the press, obstructing the First Amendment. That's a civil rights violation and punishable by jail time. Are you aware, sir, of that? I mean, I think you should tell them that just up front. Because, ooh, wow, that is just incredible that they got in your face and treated you like this before you ever even let them know you were there about the death of the chicken man.
Yeah, whenever the cops approached us and we told them the same story that we were there, talk about the green conservation efforts in different states, because we have similar ones going on in Austin, one of the nicer ones looked at Darrin and goes, oh, you guys were at the Chicken Man's house, weren't you? So he knew right off the bat, and he knew we were here. So they know we're here, they know what we're doing here, and it doesn't seem like anybody wants to talk to us. They did, however, give us the number directly to the media relations lady that we told the cops
hold on, you're
so we do plan on calling her later and seeing if she will be willing to talk to us after we make an official appointment. The cops are here now, actually. The cops are just walking up as
here, show them. Perfect.
Sitting here doing this report. And
aim the camera at them.
Yeah, turn and show. Hi, ma'am.
Do you all have permission from the property owner to be on the actual property here? We don't care if you film, but you need permission from the property owner to actually be up here on the house, okay? Can we do it from the front?
Okay, they're talking to the police here, and we'll boost the audio up a little bit over there.
They're asking us to move off the property. We don't have rights from the property owner to be here, although the property owner has just died, and it is understandable, reasonable.
Yeah, at first you were out front, but now they've, of course, the police have already violated your First Amendment, which is a pretty big crime.
That's all we have. But we're being escorted back out to the front, but very...
Hey, ask the police officer if she knows or heard about you guys not being allowed to go in the city council. Ask her if that's a new law there, that the public can't go in the city council building. Ask her that.
Have you guys had to kick people off of the city council steps before for coming to film?
By then, I get up at 3 o'clock, so I don't do anything in the city council.
Ask her if there's a law.
They gave you the phone number for.
Is there a law that media can't be on the city council steps for any particular reason?
I don't have anything to do with that. That was between you guys and the officer from City Hall, okay?
Obviously, but you are a municipal police officer. Have you ever heard of any laws relating to government buildings, public buildings, and media not being allowed?
I have not, but there again, I'll refer you back to City Hall for that, since that's theirs, okay?
City Hall, media relations in City Hall. We will definitely give her a call later on.
Oh, wait. Ask her if she's going to try to stop you if you try to go to City Hall.
Okay. Are we going to be stopped again if we go up to City Hall without calling media relations?
Not me.
She gets off in 12 minutes. We are...
gentlemen, have a good day.
Thank you very much. Thank you for your politeness. So we've just been thrown off.
But see, in America, you shouldn't even have to thank a police officer for being polite. Listen, expanding on this, here's the deal. They try to trump stuff up. Media all the time goes on private property. When the gates open, the things open, your media, it's a murder scene probably. And so we're there to get data and get information. Okay, let's just get that straight right there. Guys, what do you want to do from here? Because tell us what locals think really happened there and what locals think about the death of the gentleman for having chickens.
Well, we did speak to one neighbor who spoke you spoke about him in a positive light and said that he was a great, great neighbor. He was good to all of his friends, all the people in the neighborhood. But one interesting bit of note was the neighbor directly next door just bought his house. He said the incident on Monday happened, and then Friday he closed on his house. And spoke to whoever, he didn't clarify who told him this, but that he was told the city didn't have the money to push forward on the green conservation area. So it's actually not going to be pushed through. This guy just bought property next door. Just, you know, he's got his moving stuff in the driveway. He's going in right now.
Don't let that bus run you over.
I'm sorry, I can't hear you. There's a bus driving by.
Man, I tell you, this Skype is incredible. There you are in Roswell, Georgia, and they got the police following you around and watching you, and the other police have told you you can't go on the steps or go anywhere near it. You know, I personally think, Marcos, what you ought to do, whatever you guys are comfortable doing, but I personally would go back, and when they run up to you again, say, where's the law? So there is no law. You're just color of law. And that's so illegal. You know, you heard the police officer say, well, that was up to that police officer. So now, is it up to the police officer if I can go to the city council? I mean, this is what tyranny is. This is a big deal. I mean,
she's just doing her job. That's what her answer. I'm just doing my job. I get off at 3.
Any other tidbits, Marcos, that you think people should know?
So that was her response.
Yeah. Any other tidbits people should know, Marcos?
We're still pushing forward for more information. We definitely have a few calls to make and trying to get some calls returned. But we'll have a better produced package by the time we get back, and all of our information will be condensed by then. We don't plan on leaving until the scheduled time for us to leave. We're here until we get everything we can.
Well, good job, Marcos Morales, reporting for Infowars.com. Why don't you exchange back to McBreen there with the mic, and we'll talk to him for
Definitely.
A moment. And thank you so much. But I do want you guys to get out of Dodge tonight, because that lady was nice, but the she just wants to get off work and go do whatever she does when she's off work. The other guys sound pretty bad news, so you need to be careful. Anybody that'll do stuff like that, and I mean, you may get a police chief there, it sounds like, he'll declare himself emperor, like happened in Courtside. The mayor and city council is fired. I now rule. And everyone's like, oh, yes, great king. I mean, that's what this country's turned into. It's so sick. Oh, I can't imagine that. I can't imagine. I mean, it'd be one thing if you were at a city council meeting yelling and screaming and the mayor says, throw him out, you know, for that day. But it's another thing entirely where people just politely show up. No, you can't go in there. No. And the guys did a great job. You know, hindsight's 2020. I would just say, what's the law? So you're going to arrest me if I go on the city council. I mean, they don't want that image of you coming up and saying, you know, why did he die? You know, was he killed? They don't want that. They're scared. And it's incredible. Darrin, closing thoughts and comments on this.
It's just a tragic story. I just keep thinking, you know, I know the bigger picture, you know, could be Agenda 21, the green space, land grab. But, you know, this was a man who was a property owner that was bullied. And I think that's what I keep thinking about was the man himself. And it's just a sad story. And I'm sad to have to report about it.
And we're trying to investigate his death. Now they're saying they think he might have blown himself up, but I guess we're just supposed to believe a police department that had been involved persecuting this guy for years, that he'd been winning in court, and we're just supposed to just believe them, a group that illegally blocks the media from a city council building that's open to the public.
Well, and earlier I was talking about how he borrowed a Bobcat tractor from the mayor. But you have to understand the reason why he had to do that is to do the city's job for them. They refused. They're supposed to maintain the storm drains and the sewage drainage system. They refused to do it. And it put him at tremendous risk. And what ended up happening is his house got flooded several times. So he borrowed the tractor from the mayor so he could grade the property to help protect his land. And he got cited for that, along with having, once again, too many chickens and too many cars on his own property.
Well, I've met some of these code enforcers, and they get off on harassing people. They'll tell you that. And it's just the most hollow, mindless control freaks. And the thing is, they annex countryside, and all the time. Well, I mean, that's how it started with a gentleman in Illinois who's facing life in prison still. And the states come down and said, yeah, we want life in prison. They agree with the county for filming and taping police in public because he lives in the country. And it turns out what the police chief's brother, I think he was saying, owns the wrecking company. And the guy restores old cars. They come out to his shop. The guy has no criminal record, known in the community, fixes cars. He's a mechanic. And they hauled off a bunch of his valuable, you know, 57 Chevys and stuff. This is what America is. And then he tapes it and goes to court and stuff. And then he's facing life in prison. And they'll sleep good at night, putting him in jail for life. I mean, these people are crazy. And I can't wait to see the footage of the cops saying, you can't go in the city council building. The city hall, the people's hall, an open public building.
Oh, yeah, we've definitely got it on tape, you know.
Darrin, what about going back over there and waiting till the police get there and then walking towards it and having them say, you know, we just need this for complaints with the state and also a civil rights complaint, you know, because you're violating our First Amendment here, freedom of the press. And I would just tell them matter-of-factly, saying we can't go in a public building. This is like having to have the army get little black kids into the public school. I mean, you understand this is an issue of you blocking us from a public building and a public service.
And it's got to be confronted. So I'm game.
Now, listen, I don't want you. Now, obviously, we'll sue them like we're doing with Due. Our lawyer, Stuart Rhodes, doing a great job on that. And they're already trying to settle with Pittsburgh. I mean, we're going to sue them. Just keep the cameras rolling. Obviously, don't resist. Whatever. But if you want to accept this mission, I want you to go over there. And I would say don't try to actually go in. Let them just commit the crime in front of everybody, okay?
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah, we can do that.
All right, good. All right.
Should be interesting.
Yeah, because, I mean, it shows this city council's out of control. They think because they use taxpayer money to pay these cops that they're ordering police to do illegal things.
Another thing I wanted to point out that
Yeah, go ahead, Darrin. All right, we've lost Darren's Skype for a moment. We'll see if that comes back. I still haven't told the Karma-geddon story. I may have to just shoot a special report in here for the nightly news tonight where I cogently tell it all. It's just so insane. You know, I just want my Bill of Rights and Constitution. We'll try to jam a few calls in, hit a few final news stories here in this hour, see if Darren's video ever comes back up. And we ought to just keep recording from the road when they go out there with Skype to see what happens with the police for the nightly news tonight. All right, folks, we'll be right back. Infowars.com is the website. By the way, we have two new T-shirts at Infowars.com, a TSA T-shirt. So the Democratic Party has come out and attacked Mitt Romney's wife, their top strategist, saying it's evil that she stayed at home with her children because they hate the family. We have a photo of the Romneys, whether you love them or hate them. The point is that I am certainly envious of five sons and, 16 grandchildren. I mean, anybody out there with their head halfway screwed on straight looks at that and says, that's good right there. That makes you feel good inside. By the way, my children are homeschooled, but they go to a thing twice a week that's a school, so it's like a quasi, and it's accredited, and they were sent home with big packets about how great Michelle Obama is. Any accredited school, you're taught how wonderful, even the Christian schools, Michelle Obama is in this country. I mean, everything is run by this scum. Government is running everything. And police and others are so confident in this country, in tyranny, that they would tell our reporters they can't go in a city council building. No law. Listen, that's illegal. Just because you got a badge and a gun, you're not God. That's what I'm talking about. Hey, they take people's kids for not taking vaccines. So see, they're saying the Romneys are bad for their kids. It's evil. It's evil to take care of your kids. You got to give them to the state. There's an article, California wages war on single-family homes. They've introduced legislation to ban the construction of them because of global warming. So you've got to live in a big high-rise controlled by the bankers. You've got to rent, basically. I mean, this is such a prison. It's Agenda 21. It's real. It's happening. By the way, get the book. By the way, I haven't plugged this in days. I've never plugged it. We have all these new T-shirts. Everybody keeps asking for a TSA cert. This is a really awesome shirt that our crew put together. Who did this, Cade or Janae? He did a great job. They both do wonderful work. TSA, groping since 2001 on the back, legalizefreedominfowars.com. Awesome. And your purchase supports the broadcast. I haven't really plugged anything all day until this the end of the last segment. Infowars.com, may the truth be with you. You know, kind of for the geeky nerds out there like me. And Infowars.com on the back. People ask for stuff, they get it. People call up with ideas and stuff. So new T-shirts there. Your purchase supports the transmission. And then, of course, we have reposted the video that we first put out yesterday. National movement launched to impeach Obama. The five core reasons why Obama should be impeached. And it goes through all of it. All the different forms of treason publicly that he's committed, launching wars, without congressional approval, you name it. It's got 86,336 views since we launched it yesterday afternoon. It's a 10-minute video, right at 10 minutes or 9 minutes, 50-something seconds to be technical. And it's growing pretty good. It'll probably have 1 million views in a week, but that's not enough. We want to turbocharge this and point out the crimes that are being committed. That's what tyrants do. They just start committing crimes in front of you, in your face, to break your will and to train you to accept it. So at least in the court of public opinion, we have to say no. So your Facebook, your Twitter. Yesterday, John was going to pick us up some Payway Chinese food, MSG free, is why I like it. And he walks in at like 2 o'clock at the end of the show, because he left right before the show to go pick it up. A lot of us, we eat lunch after the show. And he walks in, there's nobody in there except one guy going, yeah, show her the video, Infowars.com, impeach Obama. Yeah, get it out to everybody. Oh, she can't figure out the internet, it's all right, just show it to her. Yeah, okay, good, thanks. And that's the kind of stuff I see and hear out there all the time. So great job on that front. Look, we got loaded phone lines here. What I'm going to do for a few of the people that have been holding the longest, like Sean and KJ and Nicole, if we have time, and got Dave and Jeff, come back, jam me in, 1 minute comment apiece. And then I've got a tape for the Nightly News. Right after the show, I'm going to tape a rant on Karma-geddon that'll be on the Nightly News tonight, 7 o'clock. Then we'll end up airing it tomorrow. I've just got to reset, but I will cover it one way or the other. All right, let's jam in some phone calls here. Let's go to Sean in Alaska, going from north in the heart to Alaska. That's right, from deep in the heart of FEMA Region 6. You're on the air, Sean. Go ahead.
Yeah, I just attended a recent class on the North Slope training card. It's something required for getting work up on the North Slope. And the instructor went into telling us about, stuff that's not allowed, such as spilling stuff, such as coffee, water, benign substances, even spit and urine on the ground. It's considered a fireable offense and can be criminal under the EPA.
So you're working on the mountains up there, and they're saying spit is fireable, and now the EPA is in control. Yeah, though, this green tyranny is everything. Wow, you should send us the info on that. That's a big article. Spitting now, fireable offense under green fascism. Wow.
I could do something like that. To get up on the slope now, I remember about a year and a half ago, maybe, you did a report about how you had to get vetted by the TSA get work. You know, it started with the unions. Well, it's now hitting, like, everybody now. It's called the TWIC card, the Transportation Workers Identification Card. It costs $129, and you have to go through all the TSA crap for it.
No, it's a license to have a job, and you'll have to get their approval to travel and to leave your house or to have a job. And you will be arrested with $15 million fines for selling eggs on the side of the street or tomatoes or having a garage sale. I mean, it's just, the police say don't go in city council. It's the Soviet Union.
Definitely the Soviet Union.
So let me guess, the guy teaching you this, he kind of enjoyed the power that he was letting you know how things.
Well, he was actually not so much for it, really.
Oh, he's a terrorist.
Yeah, pretty much.
No, I remember the name of the card. I'm always trying to explain it to the crew, and they don't remember about it. But yeah, it's the new transportation car, but it's going to be national parks, highways, jobs everywhere, anything that's infrastructure protection. What's the name of it again?
It's called TWIC. TWIC. You can go on the main TSA website, and it's on there.
Yeah, no, I know about it. I'm always meaning to cover that again, and I forget the name of it.
Another little side note I'll mention is my brother-in-law. He's a contractor on Fort Richardson, and he mentioned to me a little while ago that they're actually forming a mortuary battalion on there.
Say that again?
They're forming a mortuary battalion.
Yeah, I saw that, and they're training them all for riot control, and they're preparing all the cities for large portions of the cities to be dead.
It's pretty crazy. I'm from around Sarah Palin's neighborhood, and I remember one time I was listening to you and talked to my wife about what you were talking about, and she listens to you too. And, you know, you were talking about the TSA, and I came out of my little rural driveway, and lo and behold, there's a TSA truck passing by me. So it's just
they're just our little federal friends that teach the children that the men in uniforms grab their genitals. It's freedom. And the Supreme Court says the police are going to start the genital grope now for no reason. It's freedom. I mean, the new symbol of America, I guess, on the flag could be like, you know, your legs spread and the police grabbing it. I mean, that's freedom.
Even here in Alaska, a lot of Alaskans don't really believe it's happening, but you'd be amazed, you know, when you walk around up here and talk to people and they really have no clue. And yet, you know, just driving around, say, the city of Palmer, I was at the little Tesoro station there, and who rides in? Why, it's a TSA agent. You know, the vehicle out there, they come in, I'm like looking at it, like who the hell is that, you know? And yeah, it was a TSA Homeland Security, you know.
Well, yeah, and you heard them. Right? You're going to lose your livelihood if somebody sees you spit. And then they'll come to somebody and say, we know about his politics, Sean. Seen him do anything? Yeah, I saw him spit. We got him now. Maybe they'll burn your house down. And then if the media tries to come and find out anything, they'll just say, get your media and get out of here, boy. You ain't in America no more. This is the homeland. Brought to you by Goldman Sachs, Inc. Take a cancer shot for me. How you doing? You like dying? I know you do. Thank you for the call. All right, I didn't get to all the other people. The Karma-geddon stuff is what I covered, and that's all coming up, and I am just absolutely fit to be tied right now after hearing that last story. I mean, I know it's all happening already, but it's just, they're coming for your genitals.